Like, are you joking? That looks so pretty. Imagine just not having lashes. I'd be sad. They're low-key getting long. Anyway. Guys, I'm back. I'm gonna do my everyday makeup routine. Just gonna show you guys what it's about. I'm glad to be back. I'm gonna try to do this whole YouTube thing and make it like a consistent thing. But yeah, I have work at 2, so let's start. I hope you guys like this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I feel like that was such a informal intro, but it's fine. I feel like that's the vibe. That's the vibe, you know? That's the vibe, you know, no worries. Yeah, I'm just gonna show you guys like my everyday makeup routine. Yeah, let's do it. Let's get gritty. So the first thing I like to start off with in my everyday makeup routine is the e.l.f. Power Grip Primer. This shit got really trendy, so I went to go try it out. And it's like, okay, it's decent. I'm just gonna do a few pumps of that. But damn. I like to pat it all under my under eye because I get such bad creases. I have a little bit of a beard, but it's okay. All right. Okay, next I like to go in with my eyebrows. I use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz. What color is it in? Soft brown. That's the color that I use. It just enhanced it a little bit. That's all I really like to do. I like to go in with like very, very light strokes, just repetitive and just built off of the product. I had to like bend the spoolie. I don't know, I like going like this and I feel like when it's like straight, it doesn't really help. Like helps me like get right there. If I get right on that, but like really sharp edge. The way I hold my mouth open is not it. Does it like help me focus or something? I feel like it helps me like stay still. Enhance. Yeah. I feel like they just look fuller. I'm not trying to like darken them. I just want them to look a little bit fuller. Next, I like to conceal my brows. Obviously, I like to use the Makeup Revolution Foundation Stick in the shade F11. I've been using this for so fucking long. I like to use an angled brush. With a straight one, I just feel like it's just more work, but when it's already angled to the shape of your brow, you literally just go with the flow. Does that make sense? But yeah, so this is it, heavily used. I like to bring the concealer down just a little to help me blend it out later. And then I'll go in with a more fluffy, like dense brush. I'll just lightly blend it out. Get like an airbrush look. I forgot that I have an eyebrow tutorial on my page. If you guys want to see a more in-depth tutorial, please watch it. Okay, now that we have the eyebrows filled in and sculpted, I'm gonna go in with all my concealers. For my everyday makeup routine, I don't really like to use foundation. I like to keep a light base, very lightweight, because I know I'm gonna wear it for a really long time. And I'd rather not have all that makeup caked on, or if I want my makeup to last, I'd just rather just, you know, keep it to the concealers. So I do like to use the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealers. I like to use a few, like literally a few, like there's a lot. So I like to use the shade Rich Chocolate to contour, Deep Cinnamon to conceal, brighten just a tad, and then this one is the Flawless Brightening Concealer to actually brighten just my under eyes, just to keep it like very concentrated and in my like T-zone area. First, I'm gonna start off with the Deep Cinnamon, and I'm just gonna put that like right on my like highlighted areas, literally where my face is highlighted. And then I'm gonna use one of their sponges as well to just lightly blend this out. go in with my contour shade, Rich Chocolate. I'm just gonna put a few dots on my jawline area. And then I'm gonna switch my sponge. I'm gonna use this one. This is also by e.l.f. And I'm gonna use like the more, like this side, or I feel like this side makes much more sense, like the more elongated side. Just to make sure everything stays hydrated, I'm gonna go in with the Dewy Coconut Setting Mist, Long Lasting, also by e.l.f. And then I'll go in with the e.l.f. Flawless Brightening Concealer just underneath my under eyes. This shit's not good. It's very pigmented and it stays, like, no matter how much you blend, it really stays concentrated in the spot that you applied it. Just like has a button. Out. It's very nice. Bam. I like to bring it up into like my tear duct area, and then I'm gonna go back in with my concealer sponge just to make sure I can really get in there. Just bring it up to the brows. Then to further the brightening of my under eye, I like to go in with the Revolution Eye Bright Illuminating Under Eye Concealer in the shade Fair. I don't know what, oh, this one is Fair too, very light. There we go, look at that, that's gorgeous. So after I'm done brightening my under eye, I like to go back in with that Deep Cinnamon e.l.f. Hydrating Concealer to contour my nose just a little. So just take a little on my hand. I'll go in with a flat sort of brush, and I will just, nope, got some hibiscus, let's draw, pick some up, and then I'll just lightly tap just to create those two lines. Fluffy brush. Normally I just do it with the same brush that I use to blend out my concealer for my brows. It really doesn't make sense to just pat and bring it up into the brow bone. It helps when I like turn my head to the side and look in the mirror. You don't want to drag, just pat. And then once we have that, those two lines contoured, I'm gonna go back in with my concealer sponge and press in the center to give it that highlight. I don't really like to apply concealer to my nose before my contour because I feel like personally it gives me an offsetting look. I don't really like it. So I'd rather just apply the contour and then apply like a brightening product where it needs to be rather than putting concealer everywhere and in my T-zone and then contouring. I don't know. For me personally, it just doesn't work. So I'd rather just use that leftover product from my sponge and just lightly tap on the bridge of my nose to give it that brightness that I need. I feel like I can, with this, I can just be more precise with the amount of brightness and the amount of concealer in a certain spot. Yeah, that's fucking amazing. And it's like very natural, like everything is just natural. I don't want like heavy shit when I'm just like going out quick to get lunch with a friend, like unless it's like, you know, we're all getting donut. Like, I don't need it. After I get over with the bridge of my nose, I like to go in with the bottom of my nose very precisely with that same flat brush and that Deep Cinnamon. What is it, Deep Cinnamon? Is it Deep Cinnamon? Fuck, man. Rich Chocolate, not Deep Cinnamon. And then I like to shape like a ball around my, like the natural ball of my nose. Bam. Bam. I like to make a little button. And just like the bridge of my nose, I'll go back in with my concealer and I'll just enhance the center of that button. Wham, bam. Next, I like After all of my liquids are applied to my face, I like to go in with the Makeup Revolution Translucent Setting Powder. Then I like to go over my nose with just a smidgen amount of powder. Fucking love this sponge. You can really get like in all the creases. And then I use the point of the sponge just to enhance the highlighted areas of my nose. And then once I have all of that situated, I'll go ahead and set my eyebrows as well. Once all of my powder is situated, I like to go in with my James Charles palette. I don't know what shade it's called, but there is a really beautiful red peachy shade that I like to use for my blush. I like to use this sort of angled brush to, it's like angled and fluffy. I don't know, something about it I just love. It just blends out my, it just applies my blush very like seamlessly. But it's this shade right here. Can you see it? This shade. Sometimes I go in with a little bit of red and I'll just put, I don't know how to, I'll like place it at an angle. Like everything needs to like flow. Don't drag. I like to pat. Don't drag. I feel like that just drags the product underneath it. So just pat. And if you're feeling frizzy, you can add a little bit to the chin. And then once I figure out my blush, I like to go in with another shade in the James Charles palette with my Powerpuff. It's this shade here. He needs to make like these shades like pressed powders, like, or something, because I need more, because I literally dig in this bitch. Like I literally dig in it because I like to use it to like brighten up my eyes just a little bit more. It looks gorgeous. Can you see the difference? Here to here. Okay, so next I'm gonna go in with a fluffy brush, fluffy but dense, just to wipe all the excess powder away. Once I've wiped away all of my setting powder, I'll go in with the Dewy Coconut Setting Mist again for the last time. This shit. And then next I'll go in with my highlighter. And then I'll use like this very detailed, small, tiny little brush. Very nice, got it from Target. I apply just a little bit on my nose and on the bridge of my nose as well. I'll apply a little to my brow bone. Once we have our base situated, I like to curl my lashes. I think this is the e.l.f. brand one, I don't know. It was cheap. Really good. And I like to use the ColourPop Act Natural Defining Mascara. Like, are you joking? That looks so pretty. While those dry, I'll go in with a little bit of lip stuff. But I'm gonna try this new thing that I've literally never used before. This ink crayon by Maybelline. We're gonna try this little review for today. Can it focus? Oh, she's pretty. And the last step in my makeup routine is eyebrow gel. Think. Can you focus for 1 second? It's getting annoying. This is the finished result of my everyday makeup tutorial. It turned out very pretty, very subtle, very cute. I feel like it looks better in my mirror than it does in my fucking camera. It's not doing me any justice, but this is it. I feel like it's very light, subtle. The brown mascara is what I feel like it's giving me, like, the oomph, like, shout out to ColourPop. Whew, that was a hell of a video. Why am I, like, sweaty? It wasn't even that, like, serious. I really hope you guys liked this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more content like this. And I'll see you in the next video. I don't know when that'll be, but that's very unprofessional. But I'm being dead ass. Like, I literally might just go incognito for a few months. But thank you guys for watching. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you guys next time.
Man, I've been did that. Man, I've been popped out. And if she ain't tryna give it up, she get dropped out. Let me bust that UE. Bitch, bust that open. Might spend a couple
just to bust that open. Rip it.